Hello everybody. Today we're going to work on the center console. In a RV7, or actually most RVs and also Cessnas, the throttle mixture, and if you have a constant speed propeller, the propeller settings are available just under the panel on a separate bracket. It was also part of the kit delivered with my RV7, but I decided not to use that because I don't like it. It's taste, right? It's a matter of taste. I like it better to have a center console, although there is not much room. The room between the Vents RV7, between the two chairs, is maybe 2.5 inch, maybe a little less even. So yeah, there's not much room. So what I did is I bought a standard throttle quadrant, only a throttle quadrant, because of the engine, the UL power. I don't need a mixture because it's a full FADEC controlled engine, and the AirMaster propeller I take, there is no propeller pitch knob. Well, there is sort of one, but it's on the panel. So I only need a throttle quadrant, and I bought that one, a standard one from Flyboys, and I'm trying to integrate it in my own design of the center console. So what I did is I made a lot of cardboard templates, or mock-ups I should say, trying to see what I like the best, what is the best solution. I think I at least had some pictures of it on my website. Maybe there's also some videos on it. But now this is the time to actually create the real aluminum center console. It's a lot harder than the normal kit. That's because you have to do everything yourself. All the prefabricated and pre-drilled and set parts of the kit is very easy. Now I have to do everything myself, and especially bending. That's hard because I only have a vise, some pliers and a hammer, so it's very rudimentary tooling. I don't have like bending tables or all those kinds of things, so it's a little more complicated. And of course the results aren't that it's not something that you could sell or something like that. It's a little crude here and there, but it's okay. I like the result. There are some other holes in there, so besides of the quadrant that you can see, there is also a flap button for the flaps up and down, and there's next to it there is a hole for the flap and trim indication on how far they are extended. I'm planning on making a selector knob where I can select between the trim and the flap for indication. Of course all these things will also be available later on my EVIS. But for now, I'm trying to do things double, right? So like a backup system. So the things that are part of my kit, I try to integrate that. So there will be a few knobs there, and after that there will be the seat heaters. So there will be seat heaters in the plane, and the control of those are also in there. The aft part of the central console, as you can see, it looks like it's a hole, and I want to 3D print kind of a case holder, so you can put, for instance, your phone in there and other stuff. I'm not sure yet. It's now, for now, it's just a hole. Later on, I want to see what I can 3D print and see what is a good layout. Also, if later you want to change that, it's easy, right? Because you can just get it out and print something new. So that's it. There will be a small armrest on it, which I'm building right now. And the armrest I will send to the guy who does the interior, which is Robert Lemke in Germany. He makes really beautiful RV7, or actually RV interiors. And yeah, you can discuss with him some custom options. So I decided to make a special armrest for my center console, and he will make an interior for that. almost finished. Of course, this will not be the final setup. The idea is that I will wrap these things with carbon wrap just to make it look nice, and also I will have a black and orange interior, so the carbon wrap will be a nice add-on to that. Okay, continuing building my pie in the sky.